Hi everyone, it's Meher from Vancouver, BC, and welcome to my YouTube channel. The purpose of my videos is to introduce you to tips that will help you in your job search by interviewing experts in the field. And if you are a first-time watcher, please subscribe to the channel so that you get the notification every time I post a video. So let's start with today's interview. Hi everyone, welcome back to another interview series with me. Today, I have the privilege to interview Lars Schmidt. Hi, Lars. How are you doing?
Hey, Meher. I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thank you for being here. So Lars has always been interested in emerging work trends, tech, and people practices. This curiosity filled a career that afforded him the privilege of solving complex talent challenges and searching for some of the big brands in their respective fields, including NPR, Ticketmaster, Duo Security, and Hootsuite from Vancouver. He started as a tech recruiter in New York and LA during the dot-com days on the late 90s. And in 2013, Lars launched Amplify to leverage his experience and interest in evolving nature of work and the role of HR. And finally, in 2015, he co-founded a not-for-profit aimed at decompromising access to modern HR practices. So Lars, you have a very interesting and very good career. So my first question for you is, can you tell me more about your career growth, some of the challenges that you face as an entrepreneur, and what tips you can give to new people who want to start something brand new in their life?
Yeah, I mean, so for me, I've spent over 20 years in the field. Most of that was on the corporate side. So running global recruiting HR teams for companies like Ticketmaster and Magenta and NPR. And about 5 years ago, a little over 5 years ago, I left the corporate world to start my own company, Amplify. And really my journey to becoming an entrepreneur is probably a little atypical. I think I'm not one of those people who always aspired to have my own company and to be an entrepreneur. Actually, it was the opposite of that. Like, I always thought I always wanted the corporate job. I wanted the security and the stability of a 9-to-5 and a steady paycheck. And then, the work, as I was working kind of in the recruiting and talent space, especially as I started getting more involved in employer brand and social media, I knew that I would never have a 9-to-5. I knew that wouldn't be my reality as a corporate employee. And so my wife and I had an offer to join a company in Berlin, and we almost moved, but decided to stay here in the Northern Virginia area outside of DC. And so once we kind of decided that we were going to plant roots here, for me, I'm more drawn towards technology companies, media companies, software companies, fast-paced industries. There's some of that here in DC, but there's a lot of that in places like San Francisco and New York and London and other markets. And so I thought, if I start my own firm and do consulting, we can be based here, but I can work with clients anywhere in the world. And so that was really the driver for me of creating Amplify. It wasn't this lifelong dream to become an entrepreneur. It was part, necessity and opportunity and kind of the marriage of that.
So how you keep yourself motivated? We know that as an entrepreneur, you have ups and downs. There are days that everything is great and there are some challenges. So how do you keep yourself motivated in those down days?
Yeah, I'm probably a little weird in the sense that I really love what I do. I get a lot of juice out of it. So, even in down days, for me, I'll try to plug in. So, I'm involved in a lot of different things. So I host a podcast. I write for Fast Company and Forbes. I speak at conferences. I've got a CHRO community that I manage. So I have a lot of different things that I'm working on kind of simultaneously all the time. And so in days that are rough days, and maybe it's hard to find motivation, I'll probably start doing some of the other things that I like to do and some of my creative pursuits just to get juice out of that. And then that will kind of boost me up. And then I can, use that energy to focus on some of the tasks at hand that maybe were hard for me to get to.
Yeah, that's a great tip. Thank you, Lars. And for the audience watching, I just want to let you know that for the next 5 days, you're going to have a journey with us. I'm going to ask Lars a series of questions. So tune in every day to hear my question and Lars' answer. So for other people having any other tips in terms of entrepreneurship, please leave it in the comments section. like and share the video, subscribe to the channel, and tune in tomorrow for another question with Lars.